Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to preview the contents of a file without opening it. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So often you want to be able to see what's inside a file without importing it into a document or opening it up by itself. So often you want to be able to see what's inside a file without opening it up in an application or importing it into a document you're working on. There are many different ways that you can preview a file in macOS without opening it at all. The simplest way is right here in the Finder. If you're in icon view, then you get icons representing each file. For image files, like the first six here, you get a little mini representation of the image in that file. This works for a variety of different file types. Here we have some JPEG files and a Photoshop document, but it'll work for other things like PNGs and GIFs. You even get little previews for things like Microsoft Word documents, number spreadsheets, and Pages documents. The icon shows you a little miniature representation of what you'll see on the first page of those documents. This works for PDFs as well. Now for media, like videos, you'll see an icon here that shows you a frame of the video, but you can also move your cursor over it and play the video inside the icon. For sound files, you don't get any information in the icon that helps you tell what's inside, but you do get a play button if you move your cursor over it. Now you can adjust the size of these icons. Go to View and then Show View Options or Command J. And here you'll see Icon Size. You can enlarge the size of the icons to make it easier to see images. Also, there's a checkbox here. If you have this turned off, you won't get icon previews. But do note, a lot of icon previews rely on the app. The app needs to either create a preview when it saves the file or provide information to macOS so it can show a preview. So some third-party apps, their files will show you a generic icon and not a preview of what's inside the file. It's up to the developer to include this functionality in that app. Note, you also see icons if you use column view or list view. But the icons are rather small. If you bring up View Options, you can choose a larger icon size, which can be more useful. But another way to be able to preview files, even if you're using List and Column View, is to bring up the Preview Sidebar, also called the Preview Pane. Go to View and then Show Preview if you don't see it. It brings up this area here to the right. And then if you select a file, you'll see a preview of it here along with other information. This works for images. It'll work for other kinds of documents, and for media like videos, you get a play button over here. The same thing for a sound. And you can use this in list view. You can also use it in column view. And you can even use it in icon view. So you can get a small preview here as an icon and a larger preview here in the right sidebar. To hide this, just go to the same menu item, which now will be Hide Preview. Shift Command P is the keyboard shortcut. Now the Finder does have another view that's specifically for previewing files. So if you go to Gallery View, the fourth view here, the preview becomes very large and right in the middle of the window. The list of files is now at the bottom and basically a horizontal list showing you icons. You can click to choose a file there and now the preview shows in the middle. You can also use the arrow keys just like you can in any other Finder view, but it's more useful in Gallery View because right will move to the right and left will move to the left. If you have a folder full of images, it's really easy now to be able to flip through them using the arrow keys, see previews, and find the file that you want. And sounds will play here as well. Videos will even include a set of playback controls at the bottom. Now in addition to using the Finder window to see a preview, you can also use functionality specifically built for previewing files. It's called Quick Look. So you select a file that you want to preview and you can bring up Quick Look by going to File, and then Quick Look. Notice that the keyboard shortcut is Command Y, but there's another keyboard shortcut you can use and that's just the space bar. That's what most people do. So with the file selected, press the space bar and you get this Quick Look window. It's a separate window here that you can move around and see a large preview of the image. You can also resize the Quick Look window and move it around and it will stay there if I click to select another image. It'll stay there until I hit the space bar or the X here to dismiss it. And since you can use the arrow keys to navigate around files in the Finder, you can just simply use the arrow keys and get a preview of what's there. It works great in list view. And now I can use the up and down arrow keys here to go to different files. And you can see it also shows things like pages, numbers, and Word documents. There's even the ability to be able to scroll through multiple pages in documents. Also notice it works with Photoshop documents too. So even though this is a proprietary Photoshop format, macOS has the ability to generate a preview and show it to you. And if you select many files, like I'll select all of these image files, and then bring up Quick Look, I get little arrows here at the top and I can flip through them. So now I can actually use the right and left arrow keys instead of these buttons to go through them. And there's even a button here to show me all of the items at once, and I could click to jump into one. You can also take preview into full screen mode by clicking this button here. And now you can see it fills the screen. I can click here to exit full screen. But since I've selected multiple images, I can now actually play a slideshow and it will go from one image to the other. Or I can use these arrows here or jump to this context sheet view. I can also use the escaped key to get out of this and go back to the regular windowed version of Quick Look. Notice Quick Look also even tells you which app will be used to open it and gives you an open button here at the top right. So when I select this file and go to Quick Look, you can see it says it's going to open that in Photoshop. When I go to this file and Quick Look, you can see it says QuickTime Player. In this file, we'll say Open with Pages. Now one last method I want to show you is to use the Preview app. I mean, after all, it's called Preview, right? And if you double click on an image file or a PDF and various other types, it will open up in the Preview app. But this isn't really previewing the file. This is actually opening the file. It's now open in the app. You can now make changes to it. There are tools that you can use. You can export it, do all sorts of things with the file. So it's not really previewing. However, if you want to do something like find an image to be able to bring into a video you're creating or a document you're building, then the Preview app can be considered one step towards that. You're opening up in Preview to find the right image before you actually import it into your document. And in fact, if you select several files, it'll open up in Preview, and you can see here a left sidebar. If you don't, you can click here and select Thumbnails, and I can easily flip through them to be able to find the image I want, and it shows me the name right here. I could even go to Edit Copy to copy this image and paste it into a document I'm working on if that's the way I want to import it into my project. So even though Preview is a full app where you're actually opening the file, it can also be used to preview things like images before you use them elsewhere. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.